Sylvester Ritter on December 13th, 1952, in Wadesboro, North Carolina, the Junkyard Dog was a small-town kid who became a taboo-breaking, body-slamming hero in the rough-and-tumble world of pro wrestling. Before performing in front of a screaming audience of thousands, JYD found success on the football field. However, many of the white locals weren't excited to see a kid of color excel in athletics. Nonetheless, JYD's coach stuck by him because of his talent, which took him to Fayetteville State University, where he was a two-time honorable mention to the All-American team. After college, JYD found his way into the pro wrestling game, starting in the independent Tennessee territory and in Stu Hart's Calgary-based Stampede Wrestling. The big break for the Junkyard Dog came when he wrestled for promoter Cowboy Bill Watts in the Mid-South wrestling circuit. It was Watts who came up with Junkyard Dog's nickname, taking it from the famous Jim Croce song, Bad, Bad Leroy Brown. Breaking racial stereotypes, Watts strategically helped JYD become a crowd favorite. According to Watts, the strategy was that he wouldn't let any white wrestlers rescue JYD from bad situations. As he explains it, the real secret was not letting a white man save him. I put JYD in situations that were impossible, and he always saved himself. And guess what? Everyone loved him for it. He was a black man who was his own man. Known for his trademark headbutt and a power slam called the Big Thump, which he used against giant wrestlers like Kamala and King Kong Bundy, JYD found success in the WWF and the WCW, where he won a six-man tag team championship with Ricky Morton and Tommy Rich. He feuded with legends like Ted DiBiase and Ric Flair. No matter how big he got, JYD remembered his fans. He would often pick young fans from the audience and dance with them in the ring after matches. Although he was preceded by squared circle legends like Bearcat Johnson, Bobo Brazil, Rocky Johnson, father of The Rock, and Ernie Ladd, JYD is known as the first black wrestler to become a star of a major promotion. He was inducted into the WWE Hall of Fame in 2004. For more of these old stories, this history of physical culture, click subscribe.